action coming up for you guys here at Collision 2019. You know him, you love him, you might hate him, you might hate his Twitter. It's Dark Wizzy.
He's quite a polarizing figure, especially on Twitter. Do you see him though? He was like super chilling. He looked like he was relaxing before the set, but there's nothing relaxing about fighting against Palutena. You get scooped up in the wrong spot, you're going to be getting a ton of damage, you know, off her Nair especially. So let's get right into it. I mean, it's Dark Wizzy, like we said, against Arch. You know about Arch?
I do know about Arch, I believe. I don't know about the recent PR ranking, but throughout most of Smash 4, the prior game, and I think including some of this one as well, he is the one of, if not the best player in the Hudson region
in New York City.
And Dark Wizzy, you all know him. He's one of the best Marios in the world. He's kind of at the forefront of the Mario meta right now. There's him and Zenyu. That's pretty much it.
To say the least, you know what I mean? Like, he is the Mario. Like, you think about Mario, you think of Dark Wizzy. He's done that. His branding, accidentally, super on point is how I feel about it. Like, he's just obsessed with Mario, but...
If you're Dark Wizzy, you're thinking about Mario.
That's right.
Yeah.
Very easy, man. But now we see Dark Wizzy, he's holding center stage. But the thing about Palu, she has good tools, even when she's forced to the corner like that. Good parry, let's see what he can get out of it. No up air, okay.
Yeah, Palu has some pretty decent out of shield options. Ooh, but the explosive flame actually going to finish that stock relatively, not necessarily early, but Battlefield, you know, not the biggest stage in our current legal rule set, but it's pretty much up there. I don't know if that was kind of sus DI by Wizzy, but either way, that is going to be Dark Wizzy's first stock going down.
Yeah, Arch playing super well. Look at this. Here we go. It's going to be the Nair plane.
All aboard the Nair plane. Vroom, vroom.
What a trade right there. I mean, you'll eat the cape damage 100%, especially when you have the lead like that. Mm-hmm. So good, man. Arch is playing amazing right now.
And I love that Wizzy is starting to do that. The thing with, like, teleport recovery is a lot of lower level players get really, really flustered against them. But Dark Wizzy, he has a Nair that stays out for a little bit of time before that. And with Mario with his mobility, executes a rising Nair right by the platform.
Ooh!
And just charging it, kind of catching Arch sleeping for a second in place.
Yeah, dude, that was amazing recognition by Wizzy, getting the perfect amount of charge, getting the KO for it. Very nice stuff, but man, he's gonna have to fight up the ledge here against Palu, which is super hard. She has a lot of really good hitboxes. Look at that. He just can't get out of the disadvantage. A back air too on the other side, coast to coast on the ledges.
Yeah, dude, besides my taxes and, you know, detailing like the walls of my house, Palutena's Nair is also amazing at covering the ledge as well, especially if you're able to arch yourself back. No pun intended there to this player Arch. But seriously, yeah, he's just amazing at the ledge as well. And you can see it's working out for him really well. It's about 80%, almost 100% differential between these two players right now. And Wizzy is just definitely trying not to die. He's definitely trying to get some fair. Thought he was going to scoop him with an up air.
I love that fireball, by the way. Like, even though it didn't, like, get a KO or anything, kind of puts, like, the fear into Arch. Hold on. Explosive flame. Nice. Good high recovery by Wizzy. Just barely going over the ledge. A lot of people go right to the ledge in that situation when they're that low. Wizzy going for the finesse, getting a high recovery, but he's still in the disadvantage in Tunist.
I think Wizzy definitely expected Arch to be covering that option right there. Yo, if Wizzy... Wizzy wasn't jabbing right there. If he didn't have the reaction,
God,
that was not going to matter. The step back on the forward smash. No hitbox out anyways, so the step back literally doesn't matter. But still, the step back on the
forward smash looked cool, at the very least.
It
looked cool as hell, man.
And
it's
still definitely busted like it was in any other one. Mario's forward smash is definitely nothing to mess around with. It's one of the strongest forward smashes in the game. Stronger than Cloud's, in fact.
There you go.
Ooh, and a whiffed grab from Arch.
Okay, good scoop by Arch right there. Dark Wizzy getting a little greedy with that Nair, but it's okay. He's still got the lead. He's got max rage, too. I mean, Arch could potentially lose the game right here. Forward smash, that's what I'm talking about.
100%
he's looking for it, definitely. Right at the ledge. Oh, my God. 160. You know Wizzy's going to look for the dunk, of course.
And with the buffs to Mario's up E, you know, killing as early as 80% with max rage, as the back air is going to do it. Never mind. I was just about to say, Wizzy, if you got one ladder, you know, up E would have been killing Arch at some pretty wonky percents as we saw right now. But that's not going to be the thing. Arch is going to be able to take that stock. And all aboard the Nair plane. Vroom, vroom, ladies and gentlemen.
Dark Wizzy swung with a forward air on the way down to defend himself. That is nutty. Like, that is just a crazy thing to do. I mean, it would have won in the game had he hit it, but Arch is still swinging.
Yeah.
Here we go. Wizzy, corner pressure. Arch fighting his way out. Very well done. Just a forward air and then run away. That's very smart.
No ground game, they say.
Yeah, great.
They're just thinking too hard. Ooh, and a good back air, catching the shield drop from Arch right there. And now he's off, and the up B is not going to be able to make it back. No jump off of that back air.
I feel like even if he was a little closer in the teleport, maybe could have snapped ledge. If Wizzy reacted and just flooded, even if it was just a little bit of flood, it would have been enough to push her away. So either way, I feel like Wizzy was taking that one down. Really well played, you know, by the Mario Master. Shout out to Master Mario, of course, obviously.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying? I think Arch got off to a really great start. I wouldn't be too flustered if I was Arch. Like, it kind of just came down to the last hit situation. I don't know, man. Like, Arch's adjustments, you know, I'm trying to think. If I'm him, I feel like Battlefield's still a pretty good sage. Like, I would not be hating Battlefield, but it looks like he's going to be going to... I can't see.
Funny enough, in, like, you know, prior games, Palutena, you know, with the invincibility on her back and her dash attack, was a pretty niche matchup for Mario because all she had to do was just wait for him to commit to anything, and the invincibility stumped out any one of his options. And despite both of these characters being better, I think this matchup is actually a lot better for Mario relative to how like characters really do against Palutena, or at least quote unquote mid-tier characters like Mario, you know. So we're gonna be able to see what he's gonna do right now. Pokemon Stadium is the pick. Little bit surprised that Wizzy actually elected to not ban this stage. This is considered one of Palutena's better stages. She has plenty of space to be able to play the long range game if she has to. Landing on the platforms off of Nair Strings, which is what's going to happen to you if you get carried by a Nair String, is rough. Because Palutena, even if she's like, you know, she's falling down, you know, doesn't get the full hit, like the full knockback of the neutral air, she'll just be able to jump up, do another one, get that clean pressure that she has on the platform, you know. It's just, Nair on the platforms is just really, really rough. It's really easy for Palutena to get those Nair Strings here. So I'm a little surprised that Wizzy took it here, but, you know, it's still a really balanced stage, so we'll see what Wizzy is going to be able to pull out.
Not only that, but I mean, Mario's platforms, look at the pressure that Wizzy's getting himself, man. All the up airs flood at the ledge. Nice. I like he's going for the triple. Oh, the fireball. Oh, dude, I thought he was going to forward air 100%. He's such a forward air fiend. I definitely expected it, but either way, jump by Arch surviving, but nope, not for long, man. I mean, that back air is so amazing, but the punish by Wizzy right there, up smash, very nice stuff. Going up big time on the first stock. He only took 31%. Here comes the pressure from Wizzy again. Thing is, like, Arch tried to land on Wizzy like 1,000 times. Like, he just paid for it. Uh-oh.
Yeah. Mario's up smash did receive a slight nerf, but it really doesn't matter. I mean, that move is still a wonderful anti-air, still kills at pretty great percents, and is still a wonderful out-of-shield option that is even easier to execute in this game because you no longer have to jump cancel it. Not that it was really that difficult before, but yeah. Now it just means you can't be whiffing stuff towards Mario's back when he's in shield
like that. It's something that you have to think about less, you know what I mean? Like, even if it's a simple input, you have to do an input, you know what I'm saying? Like, it's just a little less on your... Oh, God, no.
Yeah, and that was one of the one times where a high recovery was actually the wrong option right there. He definitely expected Arch to just fall down with a neutral air and try and continue that edge guard right there, but instead Arch, with a little bit of patience right there, able to going off stage and Wizzy dying to the high recovery.
Not only that, but like, hold on. I like the way that Wizzy's been using flow too, like just keeping up the pressure on Palutena. Hold on. Good defensive fair. I feel like Arch is set. Okay. All right, Wizzy, you got it.
You know, it's just, it looks cool.
It's auto, yeah. Auto reticle, auto parry, you know?
Yeah, absolutely. That's a parry the platypus right there.
I like Wizzy not committing right there and Arch trying to find his way up the ledge. He picked a couple options, but Wizzy waited for the one that he liked and punished him instead. Very nice stuff. But here comes the Nair, scooping off the ledge. Okay, he tried to up smash it, you know? Mario mains, they like to up smash their way out of many situations. Auto reticle, not a situation where that works, but you know what? There goes Wizzy.
A really good air dodge to get away from that explosive flame right now. Both these players just struggling to get the space right now, but Wizzy still in the lead. Arch definitely at a higher risk of dying right now, unless Wizzy stays off stage a little too long, and he does not. Both of them just fighting for stage control right now. This is the slobber knocker. Wizzy gets it, launches Arch off stage. Here's the flood, the fireball, gets hit by it before the teleport comes out, and the dash attack. Beautiful. The scoop right below the ledge, and a little too antsy on the edge guard right there, but it's not going to matter. Up smash will take the stock.
No, yeah, but Arch went high. I feel like a lot of people might have tried to aim for the ledge, try to finesse something, but you know what? He went there and made Wizzy with that too. So credit to Arch there, living for a little bit longer, but either way, Wizzy going up big again, another stock, and here we go. This is how good the stage can be for Mario too. Look at the combos off the platforms and the pressure that he's getting just from being underneath Arch. It's really, really good.
Yeah, above Mario is never a place
not
where
great,
you
yeah.
ever want to be. Get juggled by the up air, get hit by the up smash, all that stuff right here. And but Arch is actually doing a pretty good job of DIing away. I mean, one of Mario's slight nerves is that it's just his up air strings are just, not his up air strings, his up air combos off of down throw are just a little bit harder to land. They are tighter, but it's really nothing significant as Wizzy has still been able to consistently land those. And he's tacking on so much percent on Arch's last stock right now, while Wizzy is still sitting relatively comfortable on his first one. And now he's just explosive flaming in neutral to try and catch his landing instead of fighting him.
Not only that, but Wizzy's shield was really low, so I think he was just trying to shield poke him as well. And I think Wizzy, like, he kind of took a breath, got back, got his shield ready, and now he can go in and fight. Especially because you know Arch likes to throw aerials, you know, forward air, back air, so you need your shield up. You don't want to try to parry something and just have a shield poke. Oh, nice, good scoop by Arch, though. Talk about going deep right there. I mean, Dark Wizzy definitely known for going deep off stage, but here we go, forward throw. Pressure. The ledge. Nothing. Good defense by Arch. I like that. You don't get too antsy. You want to throw away a set like that. Very nice stuff. And look at that. He got a nair for it. 37% two hit tunis.
Yeah, just double jumping his way back up and then fast falling his way right back down. So many players expect people to just jump off. And sometimes all options are covered if the player who has stage control is able to react enough. But Arch, recognizing that that's exactly what Wizzy was looking for in that situation, just fought his way back. But he is off stage once again, Hazmat. Let's see what he's going to be able to do to get off. And he actually fights his way back on, but he's still sitting at a relatively high percent. A lot of Mario's moves will be able to kill right now. A back air, a forward smash, but a frame 50 F smash of his own.
Oh,
he's
going
to be able to get him off, and he catches his air dodge with the neutral air, getting him off right now, and all of a sudden, Wizzy has a pretty relative amount of percent on him, but it's not going to matter. Catching his landing once again with the up smash, and Dark Wizzy will cleanly 2-0.
Watch the cameras, watch. Wizzy had the fist bump out before the kill finished. Watch.
Oh, did he really?
Watch, 100%, yeah. Definitely. Up smash, watch. Oh, he's going slow-mo. I don't know if I'm that. Yeah, look at, yeah. Okay, as it finished. Okay, fair enough. Look, it cut back at the right time. Okay, fair. That was actually really good timing from Wizzy, both on the up smash and both on the fist bump.
I think it might have been like a good half and half right there. I think he was popping off and getting ready to fist bump at the same time. Because that is one thing I will say about Wizzy. He's a premature pop-offer. For sure. Not like, yeah, thing. I did it. Like just with his fist. Like, just like because he knows, like, just in case I do lose. He's not the kind of person who, like, jumps up out of his seat, knocks his chair over, throws it at the caster, ruins the stream, you know, because the events start bright.
I wouldn't even be mad, to be honest with you. That'd be